Hello guys, and welcome to another Dawn of War Soulstorm video. Today we continue watching Face to Face Season 4, Round 3. The previous two rounds were won by Elijah. I am assuming you've already watched the previous two rounds, so I am sorry for the spoiler if you haven't. And in this round he's playing versus Zabaldiga, a very strong Chaos player. Let's get started. The first game on Blood River, Zabaldiga with Chaos, his main race, versus Elijah's Imperial Guard. In the lower left, Starscream, nowadays known as Elijah. Get started with two guardsmen, infantry command.
Reporting for duty, sir.
Two tech priests for now.
By the Emperor, you will have it.
As you wish, so shall it be done.
Sir, yes, sir.
At the top side, Zabaldiga with Chaos started with only two cultists. Chaos Temple and Generator.
You favor us with your
quick cap in this negative cover. It's very important to capture this quickly and build. If the command squad catches the heretics or even cultists in here later, it gets harder to capture this point, so it's a priority for Chaos in the early game. Elijah made the command squad. Commissar is out. And we'll now go into some sort of harass, perhaps. By the way, we'll have two sync errors in this round. In this Steam version of the game, we do not see the sync errors, but they still happen if the replay is converted from 1.2 to 1.3 version. Show me. For some reason, I cannot run my Soulstorm 1.2 retail version. No idea why. It simply doesn't run on my Windows 10. Maybe you can only run one copy of Soulstorm. I don't know. So I have to use a replay converter and watch it in the Steam version. Some command squad action in Chaos base. He killed two heretics, right? One in here and another one here. Added two priests to the command squad. Better survivability, better close combat damage. Focuses the cultists. Well, I think in this matchup the most optimal option would be to go for Commissar and Priest on the command squad on tier 1 versus Chaos and Space Marines. I think it's better to add the Commissar, but two priests is also good. You can deal more damage in close combat. They almost killed the Chaos Lord. I'm surprised. Crazy damage. And the Chaos Lord goes down. Good job by the command squad. The power of two priests. None of the command squad members got killed. Very low HP for the general and priest, but they can regenerate. And Elijah will secure his relic. What's this tech priest doing here? Maybe he wants to build a turret. This place would be good for a turret. It will reach this and this point on tier 2. But that's not his plan. He goes back. Chaos Lord being made again. More LP2s being upgraded. Zabaldiga is trapped on 4 points. No relic yet. 92 to 20 economy. And 98 to 10 for Elijah. Adds 2 more generators. And 1 more generator being placed by Zabaldiga. 1 cultist alive in this squad. You better have 1 capper squad alive. So keeping the cultist alive is important. 1 more squad on the other side. Zabaldiga finding some guardsmen to kill. Getting the critical location in the middle. Bad placement of the guardsman, he should have captured from this position.
We did it, sir.
Where is his will needed?
I am Chaos Lord. Doesn't allow this tech priest to build the listening post and even kills it. Good job. Builds a turret, he wants to get his relic finally. And goes tier 2. Both players going tier 2 at the same time. And another squad of cultists getting killed. Actually the first squad, I believe. Zabaldiga only started with 2 cultists. 98 to 30 economy. Tactical control, build, and armor upgrade on the way for those guardsmen. Both players hitting tier 2 almost at the same time. Slightly earlier for Imperial Guards. We'll add the priests. So we will have a sync error in this replay, unfortunately. But I know what the score is already, so I will tell the score at the end of the video, even if it will not be clear who is the winner because of the sync error. It will not be clear, so I will tell you at the end of the video who won and what is the exact score. My devotion is assured. Lots of upgrades for the guardsmen being made in this tactical control. Optics are done, armor is done, and now it's time for this morale upgrades. They also give a little of a bit of HP to the guardsmen, but not so much. And here he finds the second cultist squad, and now Zabaldiga does not have any cappers. He made the Sorcerer and Berserkers, a popular build back in Dark Crusade, maybe not so popular nowadays. Let's see if it will work in this fight. Only 2 guardsmen squads. Look at the Berserkers. They melt down from plasma in seconds. They didn't even have enough time to hit once with their arcs. No damage was done. The squad was killed. Bad engagement. Could have been better from Chaos. Here comes the Chimera. And right now it looks really bad for Chaos. Imperial Guard's army is much stronger at this point, and Chaos doesn't even have anti-vehicle, he makes the horrors now, and goes tier 3, that's unexpected for Elijah, I guess. Sentinel on the way. Well, only if Elijah had 3 guardsmen at this point in time, it could have been game over. But what he needs is maybe a Basilisk, some Hellhounds or more Chimeras. Another Berserker squad was made. One of the observers is quitting. Because the players were blaming something on lag issues. On GameSpy there was some connecting issues between some specific players. Ping would be higher. There's also a similar problem in Steam, but I'm not sure if it's related to the players or the Steam servers. Most likely Steam servers are glitching. Tier 3 for Chaos is up, Possessed squad is almost out. And Demon Pit, he can order the obliterators. Elijah sees the Demon Pit, he knows Chaos is tier 3. He's also halfway to tier 3 as well. These Berserkers much more successful than the previous squad, doing actual damage. The general trying to destroy this LP2 alone, it will not work. Sorcerer got killed, being in production again. Sentinel destructing Chaos army. And somewhere in this middle of the game we'll have a sync error, I believe. Very unfortunate, because this and the last game were probably the best in this round. And both games will have sync errors. Some harass with the possessed Chaos Marines. It should have been destroyed, I think. Where's our fire support? Tier 3 from Elijah. He added a Hellhound. Well, with 3 squads of guardsmen, I believe it would have been easy to kill the possessed squad. Or maybe more priests. 3 priests with fanaticism can push them back. Sorcerer is alive.
My devotion is assured. You have chosen.
And looks like we had the sync error. Zabaldiga started floating. The Chimera is destroyed. Good focus with the possessed Chaos Marines on the Kasserkins. And Elijah loses most of his army right now. A lack of micro, perhaps because of the sync error, we do not even see the actual data. Maybe this didn't even happen. But we'll keep watching. General is back. No members being added to the command squad. the game fails to read a real data from the playback file if it has sync errors. $2,000 float for Zabaldiga, 1,1500 for Elijah. Let's watch from now on fast speed, since the data is not accurate anyway. Not much happening. Lots of float for both of the players. I am not sure if these games are available on YouTube somewhere. Probably not. I think they were streamed but on another website back in 2009. Lots of hellhounds. Well, Hellhound Mask can deal with the possessed squad easily. A good counter.
You have chosen wisely.
And this is almost over.
I stand ready to serve.
We might get some information from a player's chat maybe at the end, who knows. Heavy weapon team in Chaos Base.
Nothing will get through our field of fire. Meeting resistance.
And what do we have at the end in this chat? Elijah was saying that there's nothing to counter the demon prince. Zabaldiga tells him you can counter him with an assassin. And he's right. Then we see Elijah quitting. Tells us that Chaos has won this first game. Very unfortunate that we couldn't see the entire game. I will not even look at the stats. Let's jump right into the second game. On Meeting of Minds, Tau Empire versus Chaos. Still not sure who decided the matchups. Perhaps the referee, maybe the players, I am not sure. On the right hand side, Elijah with Tau Empire. Goes for two stealth suits, Tau Barracks. Jetpack upgrade, generator, and what will he order? Croods? And maybe the Vespids. A good build versus Chaos, I would say, but maybe not on this map. It takes too much time for Croods to get in here and kill some Heretics or do a decap. Croods are very good against Chaos early in the game. They can deal with the Heretics, Cultists, decap some point. But the Tau Commander and the Vespids can also do that. So for this map, I believe Tau Commander would have been a better option. Much better mobility. From Chaos we have Raptors and Cultists. Unholy Sight upgrade, it's only 25 requisition. A must-have upgrade in this matchup. Very cheap upgrades and detect those stealth suits easily. Croods wanted to go for a harass on Chaos base, which would have been a right thing to do, but they would get in there too late. Another victory for the greater good. And Raptors harassing Tau's base will kill the builders. Stealth suit idling. Raptors killed one builder. We'll probably kill this one too. In the meantime, Vespid's also harassing Chaos base. Might kill this heretic. And a nice decap in here by the cultists. The stealth suit still idling. Zabaldiga trying to kill. He could have killed it, but he didn't notice at the beginning. Didn't focus it. Fire Warrior squad on the way. Vespids cannot do much in that Chaos base. But they still killed that heretic in here. So it seems that all the damage that Tau has done until now is only kill one heretic, while Chaos did much more damage. I think he decapped this point twice now, he decapped this point, this one. So that's 4 decaps and 2 builders down for Tau. A very bad start for Elijah, and very well played by Chaos.
Shazla, ready for action. The technology of Tau makes us strong.
Croods engaging at full HP Chaos Lord. A very bad decision here from Elijah. He's losing too many Croods and he will not kill the Chaos Lord, of course. Maybe 2 squads of Croods could have dealt with him, but not one. Well, Fire Warriors with Croods, that could be an option. Chaos Lord will have to run away. Focus on the stealth suit. Some action in here. Vespids fighting Raptors and Chaos Space Marines. Elijah doesn't notice and loses the squad. Critical mistake. Half HP down for the Chaos Lord, but also a lot of Croods have been killed. Maybe not worth it. Raptors jumping again. And here's the 5th decap, right? It's either the 5th one or 6th. Oh. Decap fails. Too early. He ran away too early. He wanted to save the raptors. One millisecond earlier. Croods can deal with the raptors. I'm not sure if he ate anything. Maybe, probably not. But he can eat the meat on the ground and add more HP to the Croods. Good defenses now for Tau, but something tells me he's behind in tech. Tau Commander also being added, very expensive. Chaos already tier 2. Sorcerer on the way. Yeah, Chaos damage early was crazy. Very good harass from Zabuldiga. Good build execution. Retreats from Croods. Elijah playing a very expensive tier 1, and now he sees that Chaos is tier 2. He seems to be surprised, but why would you be surprised if it's the 8th minute? It's about time. No tier 2 yet, no sign, not enough energy. And the relic is still not captured. We have a detection from Chaos Lord item. Berserkers are out. Fire Warriors with Tau Commander here could deal with this Chaos Sorcerer. Needs to be careful. Uses Chains of Torment on the Tau Commander. Useless waste of ability. He had to wait for the Berserkers. I don't know what's the recharge time of that ability, but it's not the best usage. We can serve you. If it's applied on jumping units, they can still jump away. Like the Falcon stun ability. They can still jump if they get stunned by grenades. Tier 2 almost up for Tau. Very late though. It will be up at the 10th minute. And that's late, especially for Meeting of Minds. He should have been tier 2.5 at this point in time. He added one more Fire Warrior squad and makes the fourth squad. Does not have enough limit right now, but it will increase once this is up. Tier 3 on the way for Chaos. So Chaos is one tier ahead of Tau. Very unusual for this matchup, considering it's extremely in Tau's favor, especially on Meeting of Minds. This is probably the best map for Tau. Good stun on the Fire Warriors. And the squad melts down. Now trying to kill the Croods. Chaos Lord tying up the Fire Warriors. How can I serve? This is a great one. Chaos has to retreat. Too many Fire Warriors. Three squads. One squad got killed. I'm surprised the Croods are still alive, but they did not eat any meat in these 10 minutes. He could have stopped in here and gained lots of HP by using that ability. Maybe he didn't know of this ability back in 2009. I have no idea. LP3 being upgraded on the relic. Very good for defense, and it also pays off in longer games. LP3s are good. Global upgrade for requisition on the way, and possessed squad. Tau still raw tier 2, no vehicle beacon, he can place it now, or go for Montka, I don't know. Goes for the vehicle beacon. Well, with this amount of fire warriors, perhaps Kayon would be better. And it's too late for Montka. If you are behind in tech, you better go for Kayon. Command post. Good engagement here with the possessed squad, berserkers, obliterators, and a stun on the fire warriors by the sorcerer. It melts down in seconds. Another sorcerer ability. Fire warriors lose morale and have to run away. Very good engagement from Zabaldiga. Good usage of the abilities and kills all the fire warriors almost. Only one squad of fire warriors is alive in here, but it could get killed any second. Cultists also melt down in a second from the obliterators and possessed squad. Look at this. What can I say? Well played by Chaos. No chances for Tau here. I'm very surprised. Elijah adding some devil fishes, his only hope. Against this army, they are infiltrated. Well, infiltrated until this sorcerer gets closer. He could jump over the wall, but it's probably not recharged. I think he used it in this attack when he engaged. Jumped and used the stun. So to make it clear why Tau has advantage in the matchup, it's mostly because of the early game and then the late game. In the early game you can deal insane damage to the heretics, cultists. They have low HP. Vespids and Tau Commander can usually do crazy damage early. And later in the game, after gaining advantage, you can out-tech Chaos. It's not hopeless for Chaos, but it's in Tau's favor. Chaos Marine infiltration, research was done, good ability. No detection for Tau. He only makes fire warriors. Four squads of fire warriors. Nice trap, slowed down the possessed squad a bit. But it won't help. Final seconds of this game. Elijah does not want to give up. He's overextending at this point. And we have a much higher economy for KS on the other side. Big generator is up. Elijah is waiting for Zabaldiga to destroy his last production building, as you can see. Won't take long. It's better than typing GG, right? And that's it. The score now is 2-0 in Zabaldiga's favor. Not sure why Elijah didn't play Space Marines, really strange. Maybe the referees decided the matchups, maybe not. I have no idea, to be honest. And considering that Zabaldiga was also a stronger player back then, he's also playing his main race. So he wins two games in a row, 2-0 for now. Here's the score. 94 units killed by Chaos, 64 by Tau. Not so one-sided when you look at this. But the actual game looked extremely one-sided. Almost the entire game was pretty one-sided. Chaos was dominating. Let's jump into the third game. On Battle Marshes. This time Elijah goes random. At the top sides, Zabaldiga with Chaos. And Elijah gets Necrons from random. In the lower position of the map. Three cultists from Zabaldiga, no generator. And what will this be? Chaos Lord. I thought he would go for Raptors. Usually that's what you will see on this map. A Raptor harass can be very quick. He goes with a cultist just to scout what's his enemy's race. He sees its Necrons. Necron Warriors, Necron Lord and Necrons on the way. Standard opening from Elijah. Gets 1 point quickly. Afraid of harass or rush, who knows. He probably expects Raptor harass. Having one LP2 against Raptors will do wonders. Chaos Lord is out. And three cultists will get the map very quickly for Chaos. Builds the generator. And what then? Chaos Marines, maybe. He adds another heretic. Needs more heretics to build the listening posts faster. Chaos Lord going into the Necron's base. Necron Lord is almost up in here. And Necron Warriors going on the right. Towards Chaos base. Necron Lord cannot fight the Chaos Lord, so he will have to go do some harass maybe. Brute Jump sees the generator and will try to destroy it. Chaos Marines added, and LP2 being upgraded. Not a very good generator position. Placing the generators behind this listening post in this area is always better. Here would be even better, covered by two LP2s. Heretic almost killed. Trying to repair and save the generator. The reparation also allows Chaos to deal more damage to the Necron Lord. One generator for more than half HP on the Necron Lord. I think it was worth it.
My life is forfeit.
Chaos Lord trying to destroy a plasma generator. Under the reparation he cannot destroy it. But it costs Necrons a lot of energy to repair, so it's still damage being done to economy. Something got killed on this side. Not sure what, maybe heretics, maybe cultists. Elijah added two Flayed One squads. He wants to be aggressive on tier 1, it seems. His economy is only plus 50, he doesn't build this. Very low economy.
We are under attack.
And another Chaos Marine squad is out. Overwatch and the Necron Warriors, very expensive play from Elijah on tier 1. And we've got an LP2 upgraded. What Chaos could do now is focus Necron Lord with the LP2 and with a Chaos Lord from ranged combat. It would have been dead. One squad of Flayed Ones could get killed right now. And that's it. Another squad left. Necron Warrior coming from behind. And we'll push this Chaos back. The third Chaos Marine being added. He will need it. Armory has been built. He cannot have a plasma pistol and grenades for the Chaos Marines. We'll deal with this Necron mass easily. Has to be a bit more faster with the micro, with the reaction, getting back from the Flayed Ones in time. Upgrade this LP2 also. This hasn't been destroyed. And what you have to do in such a situation is focus the Flayed Ones, one squad at a time. And Chaos Lord should obviously hit the Necron Lord with his plasma pistol. But it's also good like that. Dealing the damage is important. Grenades are up. Seems like Elijah's all in wouldn't work. Grenades were cast. It stuns the enemy infantry for a bit. Plus 60 economy for Necrons, very low. It's unacceptable to play like this with such an economy. plus 70 is the absolute minimum, I would say. Even if you go for all-ins like this, with plus 60 you can't even support your army reinforcement. Necron Lord on very low HP, being focused by the LP2 now. We'll need to run away. Six HP. Zamboliga focuses it and it's dead. Well, without the Necron Lord, should be very easy to deal with this. Flayed once, tanking lots of damage, and sometimes tying up the Chaos Marines. Elijah has to retreat, regroup, and try to attack once more. He cannot go tier 2, he doesn't even have resources for the Necron Lord. He's overwatching the Necron Warriors and the Flayed Ones. Chaos is tier 2, it seems. No, not yet. Or yeah, maybe yeah, it is tier 2. Well, with this army, all that Chaos needs is a squad of Horrors and just attack moving to Necron's base. Good deployment of the Flayed Ones from both sides will force the Chaos Marines to go back. Forces him to retreat and regroup. Against such Necron mass, you could also make a Rhino. Very easy to out-micro such mass with a Rhino or two. Or a Defiler even. Flayed Ones are keeping the Necron alive, because they do tank most of the damage. Sorcerer out. Chaos Lord fighting the Necron Lord. Zabaldiga should run farther from the Necrons, then stop and shoot. He doesn't go far enough, as you can see. HP upgrade was made. A very important upgrade for Chaos, the only HP upgrade they have for infantry. And it only affects Chaos Marines and Cultists, if I'm not mistaken. Well, that's it. Necron attack failed. He tried all in, but against players that can at least do a bit of micromanagement, this sort of all-in shouldn't be a problem. It can work if you do the Necron Lord artifacts, but Elijah simply couldn't afford the artifacts, his economy is way too low. It would be a minimum of 250 energy for artifacts, 150 for the Forbidden Archive, 100 for one artifact, Chronometron usually would be the peak in such all-in builds. War Solar Pulse for 125 energy could also help. Some base trade going on, but Elijah will be much slower than Chaos. By the time he will do some damage in here, Necron's base will be destroyed. Four heavy bolters on two squads, three heavy bolters on the other squad. And lots of flayed ones on the other side. Zabuliga focusing the summoning core. Wouldn't allow the flayed ones to teleport. Actually, I'm not sure. Can flayed ones teleport? I think there's one squad. One type of unit that can teleport even without the summoning core. I'm not sure if it applies to the flayed ones. Maybe I am wrong. I don't remember. Rhino with two Chaos Marines inside can easily deal with all this army. All they need is time and some patience. But the monolith is also almost destroyed. So this is basically game over for Elijah. He's losing the round right here. The score is 3-0 in Zabaldiga's favor. The monolith is down. No GG. Elijah probably upset. Let's take a look at the stats in here. Chaos kills almost 4 times as many units than Necrons. Better economy, obviously. And much better technology. 4 research count, 17 unit upgrades. From Elijah we only had Overwatch that did not work. He couldn't kill anything even with this Overwatch. So bad investment, that's all I can say from Elijah. Not a good not a suitable build against such players. It can work against players that have problems with microcontrol. Or if you add Chronometron, Solar Pulse, Phase Shift on the Necron Lord and can catch the enemy army. At least once or twice. Jumping into game 4, again it's on Blood River, Elijah plays random and Zabaldiga keeps playing Chaos. In the lower left, same as the previous time, Elijah with Imperial Guards and Zabaldiga with Chaos at the top side. A very short game if we look at the timeline. Very quick build of the Chaos Temple and Chaos Marines on the way.
We are Chaos. Chaos is strong. Enemies of the Dark Gods, beware!
My life is forfeit.
For the Dark Gods! Your will?
Capturing it was easy.
Chaos Marines out. They will be here before command squad is even out. Let's see what happens. Here they are, they will not allow the guardsmen to capture the point. It's in the negative cover. Maybe the command squad will help. Goes in to close combat to Chaos Marines. He has to do that. If he doesn't, the Chaos Marines will kill the Guardsmen. And look at this, general in the negative cover getting slaughtered by the Chaos Marines instantly, no chances. And Elijah is upset. He is surprised this happened. Unexpected damage from these Chaos Marines. If you look at their close combat damage, it's actually higher than ranged combat. So it was a bad idea to go with a general in close combat. No chances. Also, negative cover helped. Good rush from Zabaldiga, and Elijah just had to give up. 4-0 so far. Not bad at all, right? Considering how Elijah won the previous two rounds. Something goes wrong for him today.
Yes, Lord.
The final game on Outer Reaches. Space Marines on the right hand side. Zabaldiga goes for 6 scouts squads. 6 or 5? 6 squads. Crazy opening. And the generator. On the left hand side, Elijah with Chaos. Two cultists, raptors, and Chaos Lord on the way. And we have some scout harass. Not getting in time, but they could try and kill this heretic in close combat. They can kill it. This other squad can kill. Maybe even this one. Raptors out almost, and we'll stab those scouts.
Yes, my lord.
A decap in here could happen.
Scouts here.
Well, 6 scouts means very quick map control. 2 scouts harassing and 4 scouts getting the map.
Scouts in position.
Yeah, this will be a decap. So that's one heretic and one decap.
Scouts here.
From Zabaldiga.
Scouts in position.
Meeting resistance. Defile what you have us to.
Good job with the raptors, focusing the scouts in range. Yeah, looks like this squad will die. But Zabaldiga is winning time. These raptors could have done more damage if they ignored the scouts and went to decap or kill Space Marine servitors. Could be used better. No way to decap in here because of too many cultists around. The squad will die. Zabaldiga does not even want to reinforce because it's expensive. 45 requisition for one scout. That's expensive, I think. Should be reduced to 40, yes, perhaps.
Scouts ready. Scouts in position.
You can have great utility from the scouts when they are upgraded. But 45 requisition in the early game for one scout seems very expensive. Yeah, this squad will die. So Zabaldiga loses 2 squads of scouts. We'll also lose this servitor maybe, but he finished building the listening post. He's got most of the map, the top side, the middle, no critical locations yet. He's trying to distract Chaos with these scouts, win more time. One servitor down, finally. Looks like Raptors did some damage. Good damage from the Raptors. Zabaldiga does not control the squad. And that would be the second scout squad killed by the Raptors. No, wait. How?
Scouts awaiting orders.
Somehow he missed. Failed. Stopped shooting the scouts too early. He could have killed this.
Yes, most beneficent one.
56-0 economy for Chaos. Pretty low for the 5th minute. And 104-10 for Zabaldiga. What a difference. But it will change soon. Chaos Lord with Chaos Marines and Raptors will easily destroy these LP2s. We only have scouts from Zabaldiga, nothing to stop this army at the moment. First generator now on the 5th minute placed by Chaos. Very late.
Yes, Lord.
In this game we also have a sync error. Unfortunately, we will not see the most interesting part. It's not bad now either, but the second half of the game was probably better. Second LP2 down.
What is your wish? Great one.
And the Space Marines economy decreased 80-20 now, 80-30 soon.
Scouts awaiting orders.
Four scout squads still alive.
Here to serve.
Tier 2 almost up for Space Marines. And no sign of Tier 2 for Chaos yet, not enough resources. And he keeps investing them into LP2s. The timing is off for Chaos. His early game got messed up by the scout harass. And Chappie on the way.
Scouts in position.
Another good build in this situation from Zabaldiga would be Tempests.
Scouts ready.
Would have been cheaper in my opinion. Just build machine cult instead of the chaplain. And instead of plasma make
scouts
Tempests. Instead of plasma
scouts
and scout upgrades.
Scouts in position.
Just make the Tempests. If you have the armor, you can add Tempests weapons, as far as I remember. And 5 Tempests against Tier 1 Chaos would be easy domination. Take the map back very quickly, destroy Chaos base, or even kill the infantry. Tempests are good against everything. I really don't know why Zabaldiga goes for Plasma and Chappie this time. Maybe he plays this for fun.
Scouts here.
80-30 economy for Zabaldiga, gets better for Chaos, 98-30. But extremely behind in tech, only 50% tier 2. Chaos Lord has to retreat the other way, he's afraid of the Chappie. He goes on the other side.
Taking heavy fire.
Global upgrade and requisition on the way.
Yes, my lord.
Scouts with 2 HP upgrades, but still dying like flies.
Scouts ready.
Even under this chaplain regeneration.
Scouts ready. Scouts ready. At your command. Scouts here.
Chapel barracks being placed. So yeah, instead of building the chapel barracks and the chaplain, he could have gone for the machine cult and 5 tempests. Would have been so much easier and end the game much faster. But now we'll have a sync error, sync error that will not allow us to watch further.
What is your wish? Great one.
Machine pit up for Elijah. He does not have any army almost, only the Chaos Lord is up, idling, and the Chaos Sorcerer makes vehicle cap increase. Let's do a fast forward, watching on fast speed. We start seeing the floats on both sides. It means the sync error already happened, and what we see now is not what actually happened. It's very distorted from the actual game. Looks like this LP2 will go down. Assault marines were made, they can help with map control. 2 assault marine squads with a melta bombs or melta grenades. They can deal with vehicles also. War building harass. Elijah loses the Chaos Sorcerer.
We can serve you. We are eager to.
Let's keep watching on fast speed.
Here to serve.
Until the very end. Not much happening, as we can see. The game cannot read the replay properly.
We're here to serve, Master.
Those new players that only started playing with the Steam version probably never heard of the sync errors. They do not happen in Steam, thankfully. But they did happen a lot back in the day, especially in Soulstorm 1.2. I think it was the most common problem in Soulstorm 1.2. And strangely enough, in the Russian community, most of the replays played by Russian players would have sync errors. Nothing going on, the game will end soon. Maybe the game chat will reveal something, otherwise I will tell you the score, who won this game, because it's really not clear. Crazy float for Space Marines, crazy float for Chaos. Nothing happening.
The weak fight back.
Oh, what's this? 5 heretics. We see that Starscream leaves the game first. It's a hint that he lost this game, and that's what actually happened. Zabaldiga won this round with a score 5-0. Many players predicted a 3-2, 4-1 in Zabaldiga's favor, but not a 5-0. It was an unexpected result by many. But considering how strong he played back then, I am not surprised. Even later in years, in 2010 to 2015, when he came back and started to play active again, he was a very strong player. I think Zabaldiga and Maniac, lately known as Blasphemer, were the strongest Chaos players in Soulstorm. Maybe I do not know many Chaos players, I mean Soulstorm, not Dark Crusade or something else. But I think Zabaldiga and Maniac were the strongest. I might be wrong though, maybe I just do not remember any other players now. And here is the post-game summary, which is not relevant at all, considering we had a sync error. I hope you guys enjoyed this third round. We had at least two good games that we could enjoy on Meeting of Minds and on Battle Marshes. Leave your feedback below the video, as always, your likes or dislikes. Subscribe if you are new to my channel, check out my main channel. And thank you all for watching.